The intent of this video is to expose the origin of internal dialogue. I've used the writings of Carlos Castaneda, and I've taken short clips from the movie The Matrix and the movie Revolver to help offer clarity. I'm reading from the book Active Side of Infinity by Carlos Castaneda. Every one of us human beings has two minds. One is totally ours, and it is like a faint voice that always brings us order, directness, purpose. The other mind is a foreign installation. It brings us conflict, self-assertion, doubts, hopelessness. Don Juan and his lineage referred to this foreign installation by a general term, and that term is inorganic being. He also tells us that the universe at large is crammed to the brim with awareness, organic and inorganic. There's one classification of inorganic beings that caused Don Juan a great deal of concern. He called them a flyer. These are some of his thoughts. You see, the flyer's mind has no competitors, Don Juan continued. When it proposes something, it agrees with its own proposition, and it makes you believe that you have done something of worth. The flyer's mind will say to you that whatever Juan Mathis is telling you is pure nonsense. And the same mind will agree with its own proposition. Yes, of course, it is nonsense, you will say. That is the way they overcome us. Modern psychologists call this foreign installation the ego. These are some of their thoughts.
The ego is the worst confidence trickster we could ever figure, we could ever imagine, because you don't see it.
And the single biggest con is, I am you.
The problem is that the ego hides in the last place that you'd ever look, within itself.
It disguises its thoughts as your thoughts, its feelings as your feelings. You think it's you.
People's need to protect their own egos knows no bounds. They will lie, cheat, steal, kill, do whatever it takes to maintain what we call ego boundaries.
People have no clue that they're in prison. They don't know that there is an ego. They don't know the distinction.
At first it's difficult for the mind to accept that there's something beyond itself, that there's something of greater value and greater capacity for discerning truth than itself.
In religion, the ego manifests as the devil. And of course, no one realizes how smart the ego is because it created the devil, so you could blame someone.
Don Juan and his lineage believe that the predators have given us our systems of beliefs, our ideas of good and evil, our social mores. They are the ones who set up our hopes and expectations and dreams of success or failure. They have given us covetousness, greed, cowardness. It is the predators who make us complacent, routinary, and egomanial. Carlos asks, how do they do this? Do they whisper all that in our ears while we are asleep? No, they don't do it that way. That's idiotic, Don Juan said, smiling. They are infinitely more effective and organized than that. In order to keep us obedient and meek and weak, the predators engage themselves in a stupendous maneuver. Stupendous, of course, from the point of view of a fighting strategist. A horrendous maneuver from the point of view of those who suffer it. They gave us their mind. Do you hear me? The predators gave us their mind, which becomes our mind. The predator's mind is baroque, contradictory, morose, filled with the fear of being discovered any minute now. Through the mind, which after all is their mind, the predators inject into the lives of human beings whatever is convenient for them.
It disguises its thoughts as your thoughts, its feelings as your feelings. You think it's you.
You know what's so elegant about this little game, Jake? Nobody knows where the enemy is. They don't even know he exists. He's in every one of their heads. And they trust him. Because they think they are him. Ah, it's beautiful, man. You have to admire the opponent's elegance. Check.
Your greatest enemy is your own inner perception, is your own ignorance, is your own ego.
You have arrived by your effort alone to what the shamans of ancient Mexico called the topic of topics, Don Juan said. I have been beating around the bush all this time, insinuating to you that there's something holding us prisoner. Indeed, we are held prisoner. This is an energetic fact. Carlos asked, why has the predator taken over in this fashion that you're describing, Don Juan? There must be a logical explanation. They took over because we're food for them, and they squeeze us mercilessly because we are their sustenance.
You are a slave, Neo. Like everyone else, you were born into bondage, born into a prison that you cannot smell or taste or touch. A prison for your mind.
The basic building blocks for this prison is thought. The ego creates a constant stream of dialogue in our heads. It is this programming that the average person runs their life on. Get rid of the ego, and the matrix will fall.
People have no clue that they're in prison. They don't know that there is an ego. They don't know the distinction.
Beyond the entertainment value for the ego, this mental prison is designed for one purpose.
In order to change a human being into this.
The power matrix. This is something that we need to discuss openly in a public forum. Our bodies are made up of two different energy systems. We, the human, have the ability to produce and store energy. Some cultures refer to that energy as being our soul. Don Juan tells us about the foreign installation. He also calls it the energy body. It has the ability to grow in strength the same as we do. The underworld has set up a system on Earth. They call it the sorcerer's world. In the sorcerer's world, you pay out the ass for everything you do. The underworld rules us with that system. This power structure is designed to deplete the energy of the human, at the same time allow the foreign installation to grow and maintain energetic strength over the host, the human. The real sorcerer is the foreign installation. It uses the power of the human to do its bidding. And Don Juan tells us, the sorcerers of ancient Mexico, acting as a group, tried their best to buttress the impact of this disintegrating force. In our day, we have no means of acting as a group, so we must brace ourselves to face in solitude a force that will sweep us away from language, for there is no way to adequately describe what is going on. We are keeping that civilization alive with our energy. It is our evolution as a human being to evolve from this physical form to become radiant, luminous beings. It's the inorganic beings that is crushing the life force out of the human.